Kelsey, and welcome to the Exotic Feline Breeding Compound.
Come on. Come on. There he comes. Yeah. This tiger is quite impressive.
I do like the cats, too.
I like the cats because they're my favorite animal.
We were first established here over 40 years ago, mainly because of its remote location. It's still pretty isolated out here. And early on, it was discovered that cats just need their peace and quiet to be active breeders.
We opened in 1977, and we are what's called a conservation center. So we're a little bit different than a rescue. Conservation centers, we do what's called captive species conservation, which means that we want to make sure that these guys are around for a very, very long time.
Well, they're under great pressure worldwide. Their numbers are dwindling, and in fact, most of the 37 feline species are either endangered at some level or another.
Joseph Maynard, who started the facility, fell in love with leopards, and that's kind of where his main goal was. And he started expanding to tigers and a lot of other smaller cat species, which people aren't really aware of. So when I first got here as an intern, I had never heard of a jaguarundi before. I'd never heard of a margay before. But being here, we actually have over 13 different species of wildcats that we have part of our breeding program.
We were established as a breeding facility to facilitate keeping the numbers active and also maintaining a genetic diversity.
Humans tend to be one of the reasons why their environments and their ecosystems are failing. So we want to try to give back to the species and make sure that they're here for a much longer time.
Our current plans is we're going to be breeding some of these guys. These are a couple of young Malayan tigers, which is kind of a average-sized tiger. But we've got two male brothers that are about 4 years old, so hopefully in another year we'll be breeding them. I don't know of any other facility in the U.S. that has more species and more number of felines that you can see in one spot. We do supply cats to other zoos as they need them for education and display.
It's a little gem that not most people know about. My favorite part about this park would have to be how friendly the staff is and how willing they are just to teach you about what they know about the cats. And just the fact that you would never know.
We're a 501c3 nonprofit, so we don't get any help from the state, the city, any of the government funding. So every time we have events and people come through, all that money goes straight back to the cats. So that's why events are so important, and we try to add new events each year.
I've been coming here since we moved out here, my family, since I was about 5. And they've started doing some special events like red light tours and twilight tours, so you get to see the cats in the back that you wouldn't normally get to see.
We have a twilight tours, which tends to be our most popular, but that one is 18 and older. And we actually open up the back of our facility where you can see a lot of our cats that are part of our breeding programs that aren't normally on display. And then one of our newest events, which is so much fun, is our red light tour. So we line the whole yard with red lights because the cats can't detect red light like they do normal light, so they don't think we can see us as well as we can see them. So we do guided tours around our visiting yard after hours. And that's really fun. The cats are very illuminated by the red lights, so when you come out and you take photos without flash and things like that, it's very more ominous. It's very cool.
Yeah, my family and I came down here from Tehachapi just to see the wild cats, and you know, I've got little kids, so it's just fun to get them out. It's better than being stuck in front of the TV all day. So being outside, seeing some really cool animals is totally worth the time to come down here.
We have our Kids Day, which is going on. And so our Kids Day is really fun.
All right, so you guys will keep walking.
We have free games for the kids, free prizes to win. So that's really kid-centric, about getting the kids exposed to the cats early so they have a reason to care when they're young.
I love it. I come all the time. I have a membership. So this was a special event, so we decided to take a peek, see what they were doing.
A lot of people, even adults, mistake bearded dragons as the horned toad or horned lizard, and they go, "Oh, it's the biggest horned toad I ever saw."
We have a woman who comes out with an animal show, so she does a lot smaller mammals and reptiles, and it's kind of nice to have a little bit different types of animals out here, just because we are feline-centric. It kind of gives a taste about the other animals, part of different ecosystems out here. We also have lots of different games for the kids to play, so this year we introduced the cupcake walk, and we have red light, green light, and the beanbag toss, and so kids can win tickets and actually win prizes. We also do a scavenger hunt, which I really like because it's educational and it causes the kids to go around and read the plaques and learn about the animals as well.
Specifically to get children out and get them excited about wild cats, you know, what we're excited about, that the next generations, you know, of children growing up hopefully we'll have the same passion for preserving wild felines that we all have.
One thing I really love about this facility is because we are so education-centric, we do cater to a lot of school groups. So we have a lot of groups of kids who come out and their classes will study cats before they come out here. And when the cats get to see them getting treats from the zookeepers and they get to see them up close, there's this kind of ethos that goes on where they kind of fall in love with the animals. And when they can fall in love with the animals, that's when the conservation really starts. So this is Zaya right here. Zaya is an Amur leopard. The numbers do change in the wild, but there are often less than 150 of these guys in the wild. So their conservation programs are really, really important. One thing the zookeepers like to do is foster a relationship with the cat. And one way that we do that is through food enrichment. So coming and giving them treats and things makes it so that they'll approach us. She'll stand up. I get to check out her belly, her paws. And that way I can also do a medical evaluation on her.
Hello, baby.
Come here.
And if you can imagine, he's only about 300 pounds, and some of the largest Siberians can be over 700.
Good boy, you're so great.
At some facilities, you go and, you know, it's in the middle of the day and it's hot and they're sleeping. And when you go with the tour with a keeper, you get to see how the animals interact with the keepers, and you get to see the connection between the keepers and the animals. And it's so different than kind of going to a facility and seeing the animals naturally, which is amazing too, and I love that too. But it's kind of cool to see the purpose of the zookeeper, and you really get to see that here. Come here. Oh, thank you. Come here. So JJ is actually a North Chinese leopard, so he's a different subspecies of leopard than Zaya is. And JJ is a male, so having them side by side is really nice, so the public can actually see that there's what's called sexual dimorphism between males and females within the species. So males are often larger than females.
I think it's amazing getting to see all these endangered cats and the leopards, the just the bobcats, all the different kinds of cats that just have trouble with their natural habitats in the world. Just come out, see all the endangered cats, and just see what this place is all about.
I think somebody should come and check out the park because these wonderful cats are so cool, and you get to have such a fun time here, and you get to make stuff for them, and they really enjoy it.
Honestly, there's so many different cats, and the facility's great, so you're getting to see creatures that you would never get to see. We just love it. I love all the big cats. If you want to go down to LA, I mean, you can see different kinds of animals if you go out there, like the giraffes and elephants and stuff, but you don't get as much variety of the big cats. I think this one is special because of the variety that you get of the different cats. And the people who work here, the volunteers, they really care. And so you get to see the relationships that they have with the cats, which is really special.
Do you want to go outside? Do you want to have a good time that's family friendly and see some impressive animals that are being treated well? Come on over.
On our website, we have all our information. We love volunteers. So if you are 18 and older and you'd love to actually learn how to work with the cats, I do recommend that you come out. We take anybody, any level of experience, and we start you below and we move you to the top. So you'll actually get to learn just about everything the zookeepers get to do around here. Our website also has all our events, has admission information, the days of the week we're open, so that's going to be kind of our central area. We also have two social medias that are very strong, which is our Facebook and our Instagram. So if you find those are good ways to keep up with our events and what's going on here too.
Hope everybody can come out and enjoy our kitty cats.
Please come on out and check out our animals. We'd love for you to come see them and to support us out here.